Went grocery shopping in the local veggie fruit store. I don't know how you would call it, but it's basically just a store that mostly sells fruits and vegetables and some dried fruits. And yeah, they have lots of stuff that is unpackaged. You can grab your own bags, or they also have paper bags, so that's awesome for people who don't have their own tote bags. So, and you can just pick the amounts that you want, so that's awesome. And I just did a small grocery haul, and I thought, well, let's just film what I got today. Wasn't really planned, but that's, I guess, the most fun? I don't know. I'm just doing this from the top of my head, so we'll see how it turns out. Yeah, let me start. First, I wanted to show you that I got spinach, and I just take, this is an IKEA bag actually, but it's very lightweight, so it's awesome for lightweight items, so I don't pay for the bag as well, because they don't subtract the weight of your bag at that store, so that's awesome. So yeah, here I have lots and lots of spinach. It's kind of hard to show it all, of course, but let me get some. So yeah, that's awesome. I eat a lot of spinach. I put it on bread. I put it in several dishes. I also use it quite a lot for making green smoothies. Yeah, it's a great way to add some extra vegetables into your dinner, your smoothies, between your bread sandwich. Yeah, so it's great that they have this plastic free, because in supermarkets it's always in plastic, and that's really annoying. So the second thing is, and I have lots of bags that aren't very pretty, but I guess it's good to show the not so pretty side of zero waste. Sure, it's nice when everything looks similar and looks minimalist, but when you already have lots of stuff and you can use it, reuse it, that's the best attitude for being zero waste. So I just reused this. I think it was a bag for a present or something like that. I don't know if I'm correct, but yeah, I just reused this lightweight bag. But the portobellos that I got today are really big, and I'm lucky that way, but it's hard to get them in and out of this little bag. But yeah, I've got some portobellos, and I eat these quite frequently. I just grill them as a burger, and then I put them in between some buns, add some veggies on top, some tomato, cucumber, salad, yeah, spinach perhaps, some avocado or hummus, and then it's perfect burger. And I eat it for lunch sometimes on Sundays, but I also enjoy it as dinner. And when I eat it as a dinner, I add some fries from the oven. I wrote a blog post about this quite a while ago. Perhaps, yeah, I will link it in the description down below if you want to check out the recipe for this. I'll just put it here. Next, what we have next is some cherry tomatoes or snack tomatoes. Snack tomatoes, these are snack tomatoes. So I have like a little bag full of these. And it's just great to munch on or chop them up into two pieces or four pieces. Put them in a salad. But I also like to snack on these. So that's great. Healthy art alternative for snacking. Oh yeah, they also have lots of dried fruit. Today, a lot of stuff was already gone. They also have some peanut rocks with pure chocolate, and they are so good, but they were gone. I wanted to take them with me today, but yeah, shit happens. So I also got some cranberries. I hope you can see them, but yeah, just dried cranberries. And I like to use these in my oatmeal, or yeah, sometimes I make whole grain mix, and I'll just create a mush of whole grains, and I love to put dried fruits in there. So next thing is, these are grapes. These are lovely grapes. I don't eat grapes that much, but I like them actually. They are not always plastic free, but yeah, lately they've had these quite often plastic free, so that's awesome. And they are pretty big. They are lovely. So these are also great to snack on. Also, in the oatmeal, I love to add grapes. Next I have, oh my god, these are so amazing. I smell them already. I'm so sad that this isn't smell television, YouTube, whatever. So yeah, these are like nuts with herbs. Oh my god! And yeah, these are not particularly healthy because they are salted, but they also have lots of herbs. So they are really tasty, and they also have my favorite nut in the mix. This is macadamia nut. They are usually quite expensive, but I always try to pick as much macadamia nuts as possible because I love them so much. So we're almost finished, I guess. Yeah, I also eat lots of oranges, so I bought about, I think, 8 oranges. Not that particularly fascinating. Yeah, these are all the oranges. So I usually, when I make smoothie, I use 2 oranges and either 1 lemon or lime, and yeah, that's usually the basis for my smoothie because yeah, I really like the sour taste of this, and then usually I add some banana, spinach, perhaps some other fruit or vegetable, and yeah, I eat lots of these. I also really like to munch on oranges just as a snack. I really love oranges, so I have to have these for the weekend. And I also got some miniolas. These are also a type of orange, sort of a mix of orange and clementine, because you can easily peel them. So I got 2. Unfortunately, those have stickers, but yeah, I just like these for convenience, and they taste like oranges, so that's awesome because I love oranges. Oh right, yeah, I forgot I got a bell pepper too. I eat lots of these. Great for pasta, salads. So yeah, very versatile. Also eat them raw occasionally, like just as snacks. So I chop them up and then munch on these. So yeah. Also quite handy for the weekend. And last but not least, I got these baby clementines. Or I don't know why I said baby, but they are tall, so fine. Yeah, so that was my small grocery haul. Basically to get through the weekend. I don't finish this all in the weekend, but I didn't have that much fruit anymore, so I really needed to get some. And I wanted to make a smoothie today, So yeah, I needed the oranges because my oranges were gone. What else do I want to say? I don't know. Yeah, I'm just very lucky and grateful that we have this store where I live and that they have so much fruit and veggies, plastic free. Most of them are also sticker free, so that's awesome. And they are always very nice and let me pack everything into my bags. And usually it's not that busy. Today it was kind of busy because it was just for the weekend. But yeah, it's awesome. And I'm grateful. And I hope that you also have such opportunities, such stores nearby. Maybe it inspires you to check out if there are these kind of stores, or maybe have a market nearby. And that allows you to buy more stuff packaging free. I can imagine that in some cases it's very difficult. For me, it can be quite difficult because this is the only store, while there are more a bit further away. And yeah, but this is my main store that's very convenient for me to get things packaging free. But yeah, if I go to the supermarket, I really have to look, and I have to go to multiple stores sometimes to get everything packaging free. So that's quite challenging. But overall, I praise myself lucky that I have this store. And yeah, I hope this inspires you and gives you some great ideas to start reducing plastic. Maybe it gives you some meal ideas as well. Please subscribe to my channel and like this video. But anyway, I wish you a great day. Hope to see you next time. Bye.